Hay una ti, una Winnie. Curiak igusa Vicente Tigela. Hay una ti, una Winnie. Sin engaru no suena si vigani pa casa visi si vini. Sin engaru no suena si vigani pa casa visi si vini. Ay, si andina ya fado, bruno andivisa calua.
Hello everyone, welcome to a special segment on Día de los Muertos, Day of the Dead, presented by Tierra Caliente Academy of Arts and the California Center for the Arts Escondido. Cultural education is very important. It teaches us about the beauty of diversity. It also helps us reflect upon the fact that we are more alike than different. Now today's segment comes with a twist. We thought it would be more powerful if instead of it presented by me, it would be presented by kids, Día de los Muertos through the eyes of our youth. For I am the present, but without a doubt, they are the future. So thank you for tuning in. Please support the arts and enjoy this special presentation on Día de los Muertos, Day of the Dead. Enjoy.
Is a celebration not only celebrated in Mexico, but in most parts of Latin America, where there is a strong Catholic presence. It is a tradition to honor those who have passed away.
It begins on November 1st and ends on November 2nd. Please note that Día de los Muertos is not Halloween. They are two very different things.
It's not a day of mourning. On the contrary, it's a day of celebration.
One of my favorite parts about celebrating Día de los Muertos is the dancing. Here's the region of Veracruz. Y saludos a nuestras familias de Veracruz.
Yeah. hasta aquí y la noche a cantar mi pregón de Veracruz. Vengo hasta aquí y la noche a cantar mi pregón. Caigo marchinando con freno, pulpo fresquecito en la mano, pero en el anzuelo de tu amor quedó mi corazón.
One of the most important elements of this tradition is the making of the altar to honor those you are celebrating.
We will go over many traditional elements to make your altar. One thing to consider is that not all altars will be the same. It depends on where your region is or the traditions you have in your town and your family.
making the altar or ofrenda.
Your most basic altar is one level. You can have up to 2 or 7 levels, each with their own significance. Today we will be talking about the basic, one level altar.
Pan de muerto, sweet bread, as part of your ofrenda. The bones are represented in a circle to portray the circle of life. The bread is topped with sugar.
Flowers, the flor de cempasúchil, marigolds. The flowers show the path to our world through color and scent. Most altars have big arcs of flowers as a welcome.
Fruits. They represent the presence of earth in your altar.
Candles. They represent the presence of fire. You light one for each person you are remembering.
Food. You make the dishes that the souls enjoyed the most when alive. Their journey to our world is believed to be a long one, so it recharges their energy while enjoying their favorites.
Plate of salt. It's an element that purifies the souls. Cross of salt on the floor. It represents the 4 cardinal points. North, east, south, west.
Cup of water. It represents the presence of water, as they are very thirsty from their journey to our world.
Personal objects, for this is what makes it more personal, for it allows the soul to remember things from when they were alive. It doesn't have to be just pictures. A musician, an instrument, a dancer, their favorite costume and favorite show.
Toys applies to all souls, but especially to kids who have passed away. Young souls are the most sensitive, for their journey on earth was cut too short.
Calaveritas de azúcar, sugar skulls. They serve as a reminder to the living of the sweet, sweet destiny that awaits them. As you are decorating them, you write the person's name that you are remembering on the sugar skull's forehead. Just remember, they serve as a decoration for your altar. They are not meant to be eaten.
And there are more elements that can be added, depending on your traditional background. But these are 11 elements used most in traditional altars.
The beauty of the cultural arts and traditions is that they can be celebrated everywhere as means and cultural education by learning about each other. Día de los Muertos events has become very common.
Dancing. You have to remember that Día de los Muertos is not one of mourning. On the contrary, it's a celebration. So, dancing is definitely part of it.
It's a fandango, a gathering of people to celebrate through music and dance. We are all dancers with Tierra Caliente Academy, and we perform in the celebration. It is our way of giving back not just to the event, but the audience and the souls that are visiting. Because of COVID, we didn't get a chance to perform, but want to share with you guys part of our performance at the California Center for the Arts, Escondido.
Thank you.
kitchen. We are almost done. And after the video, follow us on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
There is also the face painting, which in this case, we will talk about La Catrina.
La Catrina usually wears her best outfit, a resemblance of the aristocratic women. It is a way to say that no matter your socioeconomic status, whether you are rich or poor, death comes for everyone.
Also, it's a part of folklore, making fun of death in a friendly way, because death will eventually come for you as the natural cycle of life.
It started with Juan José Posada in 1912, when he created the image of La Catrina Garbancera. It represented those women who were once poor, but were able to reach high socioeconomic status. Also, those domestic servants, seen as stuck up because they try to imitate what they are not.
But it specifically refers to those who chose to forget their origin, leaving behind their customs and wanting to look more European, more aristocratic.
It wears a big hat of French influence, adorned with flowers and big feathers.
It has votes behind the ears, symbolic element that serves a reminder to those Catrinas of their origin, as when they were domestic servants, that's what they would use in their hair.
And if we reference the Catrina Garbancera and Juan José Posada, then we have to talk calaveritas.
Calaveritas are usually funny.
They are verses to mock those Catrinas Garbanceras and the rich people, or simply reference to feelings and ideas around Día de los Muertos.
Hay hermosas garbanceras de corse y alto tacón, pero han de parar en calaveras, calaveras del montón.
There are beautiful garbanceras with high heels and corset, but they will eventually end as skulls in the pile of bones.
La muerte llegó a la escuela porque quería estudiar, pero estaba muy flaca y no la quisieron aceptar. Pensaron que estaba enferma y a todos iban a contagiar.
Death wanted to study, so she came to school. But she was too skinny. They didn't want to let her in. They thought she was sick and everyone she would infect.
Before we go, I want to share my favorite dance piece. We are dancers, but still kids. Our director allowed us to put together a special piece on Nonos Infantiles, children's lullabies. Here's part of that performance. Did I mention it's my favorite one?
Ahora vamos a estudiar las letras vocales. A, E, I, O, U. Vamos. A. O. I. O. 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 Pánfilo, ¿qué es eso?
Es jazz, profe, jazz.
Jazz, jazz, jazz estuvo contigo.
Oh,
y mire cómo él a trabajar, como mi papá, como mi papá.
Periódicos viejos, tiliches chamuscados y trebejos cuatrapeados, cambio, vendo y compro por igual. Comadres chismosas, cotorras latosas, y viejas regañonas pa' meter en mi costal. Cambio, vendo y compro, compro, vendo y cambio, cambio, vendo y compro por igual.
It's a very special tradition. Hope you learned something new.
Be sure to check out our other videos and follow us on social media.
Cultural education and appreciation is really important.
See ya next time!
Caduna di una guini, puria chi guscia vistende tighela, caduna di una guini, si niengaru nusciuna si viganni pa casa vi si si vini, si niengaru nusciuna si viganni pa casa vi si si vini. Ai, si andina già fado, l'uno andi vi sacalua. Ai, si andina già fado, l'uno andi vi sacalua. Dies puio avire nena e anagella di guapurchi tessina. Dies puio avire.